Hey everybody, thank you so much for joining me and welcome back. It's nice. This is a kind of a special episode of the Climbing the Rating Ladder series. What I'm going to do here is over the next basically 48 hours, I'm going to be playing several rapid games of chess with the hope to reach 1200. So my goal for the end of the weekend is to simply get to 1200. We'll see what happens. I'm going to release basically just segmented videos. So it'll probably be like, you know, three, four games. I don't know what it's going to be at a time over the course of this weekend. So hope you all enjoy this. And yeah, let's get into it. So we're playing 15-10. And let's go. All right. This first video might be maybe two episodes or something like that. So interesting. So takes or safe. It's basically going to be an exchange variation, I think. Yeah. So we're going to do the exchange variation here with, I think I'm just going to put my knight out that way. That's what we'll do. Most likely. Before, when I was playing the exchange, I would do this thing here, this, come back, queen, and then castle alongside. I've been doing a lot of, I guess, practice games, and it's been more of a difficulty than anything else playing that style where I castle this way. I don't know what it is, but for some reason, whenever I castle, especially when I castle long, like on the queen side there, it's always difficult doing the pawn pushes. I don't know why. My win record when any position, whenever I castle opposite side and try to do a pawn storm, I usually end up losing those kind of games. So I figure I'll play kind of just, you know, kind of a simple game here. Here, and we'll just kind of keep my king on this side here. We'll just see what happens. So here, they're going to cover here. I'll have to cover this way with that. Cover the pawn. Okay, bring my guy out. Now, mistake is to bring the bishop out here because they'll check this time and then they'll take the pawn. Develop with tempo. See. Now we get a chance, though, to expand potentially. Really, yeah, get a nice attack here on this side here. I think that's what we'll do. Bishop Eric takes it, and I don't see any point in bringing my knight out here. I think if we're going to castle, I think we might as well just really push this direction. So that's kind of structure I was going to go for anyways. There's, you know. Go here, we can, we'll take, so. Excuse me. That we could do here, potentially an early, right there, we'll cover, we'd have to Fianchetto, but interesting idea. Okay. One thing I hate about putting my knight here versus when I put it here is I love being able to put my bishop right here. It's such an awesome attacking place. But all right, so let's see. We could with ideas there at some point, but for now we're just gonna castle. This guy's got five pieces on his starting block. We can castle and we can start getting my pieces out. So, no immediate threats. Okay. I might even do this to keep the bishop out, honestly. It's not the, I mean. All right. This guy likes to, wow. All right. be a cool trick. Actually, yeah, do this with tempo because we, and then we have a potential idea of nabbing them if they go this way. My rook. Think. Come on. Go here. Come on. Right here. That's what we want. That's what we need him to go. My opponent's playing from Iraq. So that's awesome. Worry about potential with this. So I feel like developing the bishop here is a good kind of thing to keep them out. Now we do the rook check first, probably that. Keeping some pressure down there. That's an idea. To get the bishop out of the starting spot would be the better idea right now. So we'll just do that. Yeah. Come in. Is that what we got at this point? Coming in, you think? Yeah, they're gonna have some pressure here. They got this guy, all coming down on this thing right here. So, I think a queen trade might make sense at this point. Move the knight here. Threatening. Takes. Takes. At this point, then they have. These two attackers don't really have anything. Is there a better way to do it? Interesting. Love that. That's what they're going to go for, something like that. My guess is they do not want to get their queen straight off right now with all this, you know, you got three guys right here just all barreling down on this, these spots right here. This is, I mean, yeah. So we'll do that first. So we'll take, must take back that way. Then we'll take this way. All right, there's no, I take this way first, just for context, this is a problem. It's a big problem. So we gotta trade that way first. Potential idea there. Discovered check idea. Some nice juicy ideas. Okay. Take here. Potential check ideas, but I think this one's the stronger idea because they're going to have to push their bishop down and the king's going to take. I don't know, because I could do this first. If they went here, that would be interesting. So pawn storming on that side, huh? Alright, so we get some ideas here. I like that move. I like it a lot. Here, here, here. I feel like I'll get the king on castle either way, but I feel like I've helped develop a piece, both his pieces, if I do that. most direct thing. Cool, now we can start getting my bishop out here. Okay, so bring them back. We could even down here takes open up my rook more. This last guy out. Alright, so we can go here. Oh, thank God. Yeah. I don't even mind doubling these pawns up right here. It's like, I'll make Loof this way. Yeah. Okay. Cool. The problem is there a way to get that thing quickly? My knight, any way to get here real fast? No, okay. We could go that way, couldn't we? Which way? He's gonna put his rooks on this file right here. That's what's gonna happen. Yeah, we're gonna block it right here. We're gonna stop this pawn from ever coming down. Move the king over, get the rooks right here. They come down, we'll trade them like that. Only problem is all these guys are locked on light squares. That's the only... So it should be this. It should be this with this guy right here. At this point, this bishop's not going anywhere. It's not doing anything. Okay. Oh, that'd be funny. That would keep him out all pretty much all day, huh? That would be kind of rich. Could just do that. Doesn't matter. Let's start pushing this pawn here in this way. You gotta start moving a little bit quicker. I got 6.5 minutes left. And yeah, I don't like that pawn coming down. I don't like it. Well, at this point, we could be okay, actually. Because the rook can't come in and threaten me, so I can always go back if they push and just take it. Right? And get in here and start threatening these pieces. Could do that. Start pushing this for a minute. Let's put a little bit of pressure on this side. Get the other rook out here. That would keep him out. That would keep him out, wouldn't it? At this point, I can start getting my rook over here on the open. Yeah, I could do that. Oh, could do that. King's got a chance to get these guys down here. Wait, my next. This point, with this, let's get my knight out here. I think at this point we're good. I like controlling this file right here, but I would have preferred having both these rooks traded off. I think this would have been much more favorable to me, just because we can't double it up, but I didn't want to give, well, it wouldn't have, well, maybe it would have, yeah. Now this is where we can go. It locks my knight in place here. It'll lock my knight. Basically, it won't have anywhere to go, but this piece can't come down ever. And it doesn't matter. We don't have to worry about that right now. Alright. This card's this square. So now we're in here. We can now... Man, I like it though. I like it because that way I can start moving my piece. I don't have to worry about this guy come down threatening to take here. I can get my rooks double up in this file. Let's do it. That'll be here. Nothing can take it. These cover it right here. And now I can get my rooks double up and they can't. This guy covers here. So they can't ever do this sort of attack. Let me start getting my guys on this side. Start, you know, cleaning house basically. Yeah, the length of these games, I think I'm going to be doing probably just like two at a time or something like that, and taking short breaks in between. I might actually just call it this game for now. Just upload this one game by itself. These things, yeah, these are long games. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, here we go. There it is. That's what I was waiting for. Here, start trading off, start putting pressure down on this guy here. If he comes for any of these pieces, we'll just move our rook over to it. Okay. King moves, we're getting a free bishop. Okay. Figures double him up makes the most sense. Oof, we could. I think we can check, right? Check. Check, it'll. Yeah, it takes, though. Yeah, they. Yeah, there's no way to check the king away from this bishop here. Yeah, but he goes there. Okay. Oh, please do that. Well, no, wouldn't no, cause, yeah, this guy. All right. Let's get my king. Start getting my king somewhat over here. My king on the side, down here. Push the rook, get my king just. Yeah. Pressure on him. Get this guy up here to cover that as well. Get my king. How am I going to get my king? Yeah, it's a minefield of a position. Gotta bring him back. Yep, gotta bring it back. Okay. We go. Now we can start getting some fight on. Yeah. Yeah. Got some tentative ideas here. Okay, here we go. Yeah, we gotta move quick. Gotta move quick. Yeah, see, I was hoping mate. Yeah, okay. Pin. Here we go. Taking the free piece. We're taking the free piece. Hold on. Yeah, there might have been a way to checkmate him right there. I got 2 minutes here, so I'm rushing a little bit of the time. You got him. Hold on. We got him. We got him. Actually, gotta check that way. Got him. So, this and this. We got him. Woo! All right. Gonna call here for this first video. Thanks so much for watching. I'll have more later this afternoon. Three mistakes, two blunders ended up being the whole thing. If I was to do a whole analysis right here, it'll say I played 6-7% accurate. So. Not great, but we got the win. So, thank you so much.